It's a milestone election for the state of Tamil Nadu. When leaving out Vellore, all other parliamentary constituencies will be voted for on April 18th. By-polls will also be held for 18 assembly segments in the state. The first major election after the passing of stalwart leaders J. Jayalalitha and M. Karunanidhi, the AIADMK and DMK are fighting a battle that will shape the region's politics for years to come. While the AIADMK is part of NDA, the DMK and Congress are partners. One of the most closely watched battles in the state will be for the Thoothukudi constituency, with two high-profile women candidates. Karunanidhi's daughter, M. Kanimodi, is contesting her first Lok Sabha election. She is currently a Rajya Sabha member. Kanimodi faces off against BJP State President Tamilisai Sundararajan in this constituency, and it's a battle of pride between the two parties. Another constituency to watch is Sivaganga, from where former Finance Minister P. Chidambaram's son Karthi is in the fray. It's a direct Congress-BJP fight here, as Karthi faces off against a fiery BJP state leader H. Raja after the AIADMK released this seat for its saffron ally. Fewer seats will be voted for in states like Assam, Bihar, Chhattisgarh, Jammu and Kashmir, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Manipur, Odisha, Uttar Pradesh and West Bengal. Another 8 seats out of 80 go to the polls on 18th April in Uttar Pradesh. While Nagina, Bulandshahr, Hathras and Agra are reserved constituencies, Amroha, Aligarh, Mathura and Fatehpur Sikri fall in the general category. Rural distress is a key issue for these constituencies in western Uttar Pradesh, but the wave of nationalism created by the BJP is also likely to count. A key constituency to protect, one that helps BJP build on its Hindutva narrative, is the birthplace of Lord Krishna, Mathura. Incumbent MP Hema Malini is contesting against Kuvar Narendra Singh of the RLD. Hema Malini had defeated the sitting MP Jayant Chaudhary from RLD by 3.3 lakh votes in 2014. But not all poll pundits are sure she will be able to win with that big a margin. In Karnataka, 14 out of 28 constituencies are going to vote on the 18th of April. These include 4 Bangalore constituencies and other crucial ones like Mysore, Kolar and Tumkur. Another key constituency in Karnataka is Mandya, where the fight is between actor-turned-politician Nikhil Gowda and Sumalata Ambarish. Nikhil is the son of H.D. Kumaraswamy and the grandson of H.D. Devagoda. And Sumalata is wife of late Kannada superstar Ambarish. She is contesting as an independent but is being backed by the BJP. In Maharashtra too, 10 constituencies will be voted for in the second phase. These include Nanded, Solapur, Bid, Amravati, Osmanabad and others. Farmer distress and water scarcity are key issues for most of the 10 constituencies being polled on April 18th. A constituency to be watched is Nanded, where sitting MP Ashok Chavan is hoping to be re-elected, even as the BJP has been pushing to create inroads in this Congress stronghold. Ashok Chavan is pitted against Chikalikar Pratap Govind Rao from the BJP and Abdul Samad from the Samajwadi Party.